What actually happens the moment a venomous snake sinks its fangs into you? Is it instant pain? Do you die in minutes? Or does your body begin a terrifying chain reaction deep beneath the skin? Today, we're breaking down exactly what happens inside your body, second by second, minute by minute, after a venomous snake bite. Whether it's a cobra in India, a rattlesnake in Arizona, or a viper in sub-Saharan Africa, the effects are real, and the clock is always ticking. Let's say you're hiking. You step near a log and strike. A snake hits your ankle. It takes just 0.15 seconds for the snake to bite and withdraw. But in that instant, two hollow fangs act like hypodermic needles, delivering venom into your tissue. Here's what's happening. The fangs pierce your skin and underlying tissue, sometimes even nicking small blood vessels or nerves. Venom doesn't just sit there. It spreads rapidly, riding through the lymphatic system toward your bloodstream. If it's a neurotoxic venom, like from a cobra or mamba, your nerves are the first target. If it's hemotoxic, like from a viper, it attacks your blood and tissues directly. And the clock has started. Every minute matters. Now, let's break it down, minute by minute. Between 1 to 5 minutes, pain begins near the bite, often burning, throbbing, or radiating. Redness and slight swelling start to appear. In some cases, you'll feel nothing at all yet, which is more dangerous. Between 5 to 10 minutes, venom reaches nearby lymph nodes and begins circulating. You may feel dizziness, nausea, or a metallic taste in your mouth. If it's neurotoxic, early symptoms may include slurred speech, drooping eyelids, and blurred vision. Next, between 10 to 30 minutes, hemotoxic venom starts destroying tissue and breaking down capillaries. Bruising spreads rapidly. Skin may start to turn purple or black around the wound. You'll feel intense fatigue. Heart rate increases to compensate for dropping blood pressure. And between 30 to 60 minutes, without treatment, tissue necrosis worsens. Vomiting, shortness of breath, and confusion can set in. For neurotoxins, muscle paralysis begins, including chest muscles, making breathing difficult. If left untreated, this is when many bites become fatal. Now, there are three major types of snake venom, and they attack your body differently. 1. Neurotoxic venom, common in cobras, mambas, crates. This targets the nervous system, blocks signals between nerves and muscles, leads to paralysis, especially of respiratory muscles. Death can occur from asphyxiation, not heart failure. 2. Hemotoxic venom, common in vipers and rattlesnakes. This destroys red blood cells, tissues, and blood vessels, causes internal bleeding, massive swelling, and organ damage, and can lead to kidney failure due to massive tissue breakdown. 3. Cytotoxic venom, common in puff adders and some vipers. This destroys cells directly around the bite area, leads to severe necrosis. In some cases, limbs require amputation. Some snakes, like the boomslang or Russell's viper, deliver a mix of these venom types. Their venom is a cocktail of death. So what determines whether you survive? The factors that increase your chances include: 1. Quick medical attention. The golden window is usually within 30-60 minutes. 2. Anti-venom availability. This works by neutralizing venom in the blood. 3. Correct identification. Knowing the snake type helps doctors give the right antivenom. Now, the factors that make it worse. 1. Delayed treatment. 2. Bites from species with fast-acting venom, like black mamba. 3. Bites to the face, neck, or torso, where venom spreads faster. And 4. Children or smaller adults. This is because venom to body ratio is higher. So, what's the road to recovery? Surviving the bite is just the beginning. Recovery can take months, depending on tissue damage. You may need skin grafts, physical therapy, or even amputation. Psychological trauma is also real. Many survivors develop PTSD from the experience. Some people suffer permanent nerve damage, scarring, or loss of mobility. Fun fact: the average snake injects only part of its venom per bite. In some cases, it's a dry bite. That means no venom at all. But can you afford to gamble? So let's recap. What really happens when a snake bites you? Your body enters a battle, a race against time, to survive a natural weapon that's evolved for millions of years. Some bites only hurt, some kill, but all demand respect. So remember, stay alert in snake-prone areas. Never try to suck out venom. It doesn't work. And always seek medical help immediately. If you found this breakdown helpful, hit the like button and subscribe for more wildlife survival stories, nature facts, and snake secrets. Got a snake bite story of your own? Drop it in the comments. See you next time.